Hey, this is Tim Pierce. That was me pretending to be the second guitar player in U2. Quite a fantasy. Those are the parts I would have played if I had been invited to the session on the day they recorded that song. I know it's a reach, but a pretty fun exercise. Today we're going to talk to five veteran touring musicians and artists. We're going to visit with Dave LaVita, who tours and records with Tim McGraw, Bruce Watson with Foreigner, John Shanks with Bon Jovi, Victor Andrizzo with Alanis Morissette, and my old boss, Rick Springfield. We're going to talk about what they think is going to happen and when it's going to open up and when they're going to be able to go back out on the road. The thing I got from this that I didn't expect is the resilience of all these guys staying home, waiting patiently, knowing that the future is uncertain, doing the best they can with the cards they've been dealt. Pretty great. Every tour has musicians, and in Rick's case, he's the one who hires the musicians. But every tour also has dozens, if not hundreds, of other professionals who work very, very hard to keep the thing going. I spent about 4 years doing Phil Collins records. I never toured with him. He asked. I politely declined because I wanted to stay home and do sessions. That's a whole nother story. But his tour manager told me when they were on the road at their peak, after 12 months of being on the road, he actually met somebody new that he was touring with that he hadn't met yet. That's an army of professionals. So it's not only the musicians, it's the riggers, the guys who go up into the ceiling, you know, at 6 or 7 in the morning when they arrive and rig everything so that they can hang the PA. It's the caterers, it's the bus driver, it's the truck driver, it's the security people, it's the guitar tech. All of these people need to go back to work, and I'm looking forward to the day when they can. There's a link right below if you want to check out the free trial in the online masterclass.
Dave LaVita tours with Tim McGraw. Dave is a ferocious guitar player, and Tim treats his musicians like royalty. There's a new record called Here on Earth that has Dave LaVita and Mike Landau and a bunch of other great guys on. It's a great record. I love Tim's music. So Dave is hunkering down, and he's got a deluxe setup in the bathroom next to his studio, and he uses his Kemper. So he's doing sessions. He's available for sessions if you need him, but he's going to weigh in on what it's like for him and when he thinks the world will open up.
You know, since I've known him, he's never been content to sit back on his previous accomplishments. He's always trying to tell better stories, stories that he thinks are important and beautiful, and, you know, make his records sound better and better if he can somehow. I have heard that they've, you know, begun booking shows for next year. Now that there's vaccines coming in, things will settle down, things will become calmer, and I think hopefully the science will pick up speed, which will help, you know, facilitate us all being able to hang out in large groups together without fear of, you know, people getting sick. So it could be next summer. Being a musician, especially a freelance musician or whatever, don't ever assume anything, because gigs get canceled, sessions get canceled at the last moment. You know, it's just, and so you've learned to live with that, and you learn also not to look too far ahead.
You've seen John Shanks on my channel. He and Phil X, who've also been on my channel too, are the guitar players in Bon Jovi. John co-produces, co-writes, and plays in the band. And he has a little different take on things because they released a record recently and they're releasing singles. And so he's looking at it from the perspective of promoting a record, and it's slightly different.
You know, the interesting thing is also record releases, you know, people pushing records back and trying to find windows of opportunity. And then it's trying to figure out how to market or promote stuff. So, you know, here's projects. I mean, I heard yesterday, for example, like, I guess the Foo Fighters record's going to come out in February, you know, even though their single came out. So as far as touring, there's been no, I've not heard any specific dates. I think the wish is fall 2021. I mean, I've heard talk that we might do a whole nother album before that. You know, that means starting from scratch again, even though in a sense we would have been promoting this record that just came out. After a while, when you kind of put out singles, you know, what happens then? You know, do you need new material to promote the tour that you're going? It's everything's kind of up in the air, and I guess more will be revealed.
Bruce Watson has been the touring guitar player in Foreigner for a long time. Mick Jones, the original guitar player, songwriter, kind of founder of the band, he comes out at select fun gigs and joins them, but Bruce is always there. It's a pretty happy family. They love doing it. They tour constantly. they have a little different strategy. They're going to try and start in Canada and then go to Europe. But just like everybody else, they keep pushing things back, and it's still not a definite plan.
Even the most people with the most information don't have enough information to make any secret plans. Everyone's still guessing. And in the last couple of days, with the talk of the real talk of inoculation, is encouraging. And from our point of view, what they've done management wise is they put gigs on the books. We had gigs. We've never not had gigs on the books since last March. And right now, the beginning point, they keep pushing it back when they see that, well, that's never going to happen. But I think it's been wise to just structurally keep things in place, so when the time is right, we can just plug into it. So we, at the moment, are scheduled to start in May, like May 16th or mid-May. One could say that's questionable, but it's not completely unrealistic at this point. So we have gigs scheduled in May in Canada, and then there's another block that starts in June in Europe. Probably like 4 or 5 weeks in Europe. Some anchor gigs, some festivals around which other gigs, I think, could be filled in.
Victor Andrizzo is one of the top session drummers here in LA. They also fly him to Nashville to do records. He just went and came back for something. Victor actually was very resourceful during this period of time. He created a studio in his garage, and it sounds really great. I actually had him do a track for me not too long ago, and it sounds really, really amazing. And he'll have that moving forward now. But he tours with Alanis Morissette. And once again, they're kind of a family. They can't wait to go back out. Here's his take.
Alanis has a tour planned for next year. And as of now, we are still operating under the assumption that we are going out on the road in the summer. Everything is subject to change, of course. I guess that's the thing. It's so hard to say anything definitively at this point in time. But my youngest daughter said, picture it and it will happen. So I'm going to take her advice. Luckily, the tour we have planned is a lot of outdoor places since it's summertime. And I think we even start at the Hollywood Bowl, hoping that happens. I don't know if people will be distanced or I suppose it also depends how readily available a vaccine will be for everybody and then how many people will take a vaccine. But we'll be amazing to have that exchange again. I can't imagine how emotional it's going to feel to be playing music and have people there and that exchange happen once again. It would be pretty beautiful.
Rick Springfield and I have known each other for a long time. I did all of his tours and all of his records in the 80s, right after Jesse's Girl. That was Neil Giraldo. I joined the band right after that, and it was really fun. And I still work with him. One of the reasons I still work with him is he never stops working. Every time he comes off the road, he's busy. But he had a really interesting point about the fact that venues, some are shutting down, and the ones that will be available when the world opens up again are going to be in high demand. And everybody, all of these bands and all these artists are going to want to get into these venues, and they're not going to be enough of them, perhaps.
Looks like you're recording today.
Yes, we're recording. I have not stopped recording. I've recorded 3 albums so far. Looking forward to playing live, though.
Have you heard any information about when things might open up, or your management, your agents, your people?
I don't have people. No, I have people. I have people. They're saying middle of next year, possibly. It depends on the vaccine, I guess. If it actually going to happen, if it'll actually get to people. It's going to be interesting because there's a lot of venues have closed through the whole lockdown. They haven't been able to afford to stay open. So I think there's going to be, every musician is burning to get out and play. But when we finally do it, there's going to be a lot less venues. I suggested we all get together and do just a stadium tour of everybody. One song and off. It's a 5-hour show. And there'd probably be a little ego fighting over who's the closer. but I think that's probably going to be the only solution, because there's going to be a lot of people want to play. And I think a lot less venues than they were at the start of this whole shit show.
Thanks for weighing in. I know you probably have another 8 hours of overdubbing to do, because it's only
3 o'clock.
I don't do overdubs, Tim. Everything I do is completely live. There's no tuning. There's no time correcting. It's all just natural and good.
Well, great. You should be able to finish another couple of records in the before dinner then.
I think, at least a couple of tracks, full tracks, mixed, done, released.
Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, please hit the subscribe button and ring the bell. If you are a subscriber, please ring the bell. It lets us let you know every time a new video is released. You can also support us by clicking the link below for the online masterclass. As I always say, we're up to over 100 hours of lessons and content, over 1,000 videos. There's a 14-day free trial. Take your time, take a long look. We'd love to have you join us.